terrorists. No masks? You think pointing guns at protesters is nice? It's fun? You think you're cool? Abolish the suburbs! Abolish the suburbs! Abolish the suburbs!
It's time to get real. The video that you just watched was posted on social media yesterday of a woman clearly stalking and then harassing Mark and Patricia McCloskey. You'll recall that's the St. Louis couple who made national headlines back in June when violent protesters broke down a gate to their private community, trespassed on their private property, and then made verbal threats towards the couple. That's when they pulled out their guns and stood guard in front of their home on their property. Of course, certain local and national politicians, along with the St. Louis district attorney and the mainstream media, have all but convicted the couple of a crime. Even though after watching the video, you clearly can hear threats being made, and the couple, both being lawyers, followed the law and stood their ground on their private property, as the law actually states in the state of Missouri. They have a stand your ground defense. It is completely legal. Mind you, no shots were fired, no one was injured. But since this whole debacle went down over 3 months ago, the couple has been vilified by the press, the left, and the BLM movement, who, of course, was leading the charge that day when protesters broke that gate down. So to the woman screaming and yelling profanities and calling for an end to the suburbs and F your guns, I say this. Get real, lady. You and your extremists need to calm down. Let the judicial system work. You'll most likely not like the results when this case actually concludes, because Missouri's governor and even the president have stated that if the corrupt left-leaning DA in St. Louis does somehow miraculously manage to pull off a guilty verdict, the McCloskeys will be pardoned, as they should. No matter what you think of them or how the images you've seen portrayed about them, they did nothing wrong, and they don't deserve this constant stalking and harassment. Just for a moment, imagine it's you. Now, whether or not you live in a small apartment in a major city or a modest home in the suburbs or a ranch in the country, you've been watching for weeks as our cities burn across America. Then an angry mob of hundreds comes storming down your street, screaming and yelling threats. You're inside with your family. You want to keep safe. You want to keep the things that you've worked your entire life for secure and safe, whether it's just a little you have or a lot, like the McCloskeys. So you step outside. You begin hearing these threats to you and your family. What would you do? The Second Amendment was created for our safety, the American people, primarily to defend against a tyrannical government. But it also allows you to protect and defend what's yours. And I, for one, say thank God for the Second Amendment, especially in the world we live in today, where we praise and raise up the bad guy and degrade and spit on law and order, law enforcement officials, and hardworking Americans for just simply doing what's right, using their Second Amendment right to defend themselves. So to the agitators and that woman in the video and the rioters that are hell-bent on stalking this poor couple for simply doing what I think most Americans would do in this crazy situation, get real and get a life. I hope that you never need law enforcement or a weapon to defend yourself or your family from harm, because if or when that day comes, remember, the Constitution and the law will protect you from people like you. So do us all a favor and get real. All right, that's going to do it for our show tonight. We thank you so much for tuning in to Real America here on One America News. If you'd like to reach out to the show, have any comments, or would like to be a guest or nominate someone for our Patriot Report, you can check us out on OANN.com. We really hope you like the show and you tune in tomorrow. Don't forget, programming note, beginning next Monday, September 28th, Real America is moving up in the time slot. It's 5 p.m. Pacific, 8 p.m. Eastern. Make sure you write that down. Tomorrow, though, I'll see you at the same time right here. But until then, remember, folks, be proud, be safe, and God bless.